Hey, boy. Hey, look at Papa's boy. Look at him. Say, in his stand-up. All right, now you biggest rest the rest of the boys now. Say hi. Say, here I am, world. My name is Mari. That's right.
I dream of a city called glory, so bright and so fair. When I entered the gates, I cried, holy, the angels all met me there. They carried me from mansion to mansion. I saw, then I said, I want to seek Jesus. He's the one who died for all. Then I bowed all my knees and cried, holy, thou art holy. I clasped my hands and sang glory, glory to the Son. Then as I entered the gates of that city, my loved ones all knew me well. They took me down the streets of heaven. Talked with Mark, sat down with my dad. Oh, but I said, Dad, it's so good to see you, but I want to see Jesus.
picture.
Mama! Handsome man, look at you!
I want to welcome everyone today. We're going to open up in prayer. So let's bow our heads and look to the Lord. Precious, kind, Heavenly Father, again, we thank Thee and praise Thee for Thy goodness unto us today, for Your many blessings unto us today, dear Lord. Certainly, it's a sad occasion today, dear Father, that we're laying our dear brother to rest. But we ask and pray today that You would just manifest Yourself in our midst, dear Lord, and in the services that are going forth today, dear Father. We ask and pray, Lord, that You would be with the family, be with brother and sister Morris, dear Lord, and that You would just be a comfort unto them today. Again, Father, we ask and pray that You would just order every aspect of this service, dear Lord, and we leave it in Your hands. We'll be sure to thank Thee and praise Thee for all that's done and accomplished for Thee. We ask it all in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. At this time, we're going to ask Sister Marianne Jameson to come and play an opening musical selection. You can bring Briella with you. Yeah. We're going to ask Pastor Willie Hoskins to bring us a Old Testament scripture reading.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Amen. We thank God for being here. We do honor the Spirit of Christ. Amen. Each and every one who is here. And our prayers go out to the bereaved family. Amen. I'll be reading from Job 19. I'll be starting at the 24th verse. And it reads, that they were graven with an iron pen and laid in rock forever. For I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And although after my skin warms, destroy the body, yet in my flesh shall I see God. May God bless the reading of his word. Amen.
Now we're going to ask Minister Joseph Lindsay to bless us with the New Testament scripture reading.
Praise the Lord, everybody. I do give an honor to God for my being here this morning. Amen. And to my aunt and uncle, y'all keep doing what you was doing. Amen. God got you. New Testament scripture reading is coming from John chapter 14. Let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. Amen. May God bless the reading of his word.
We're going to ask Deacon Charles Alexander to come and deliver the prayer of comfort.
Good morning, family and friends. I'd like to read a verse before I offer prayer. It's Matthew 19:14. But Jesus said, let the little children come to me and do not hinder them, for to such belongs the kingdom of heaven. So let us bow our heads in prayer. Heavenly Father, we come to you this morning, Lord, with heavy hearts, not understanding your way, but we know that you are definitely in control. Your will must be done. I offer prayer now this morning for the Morris family and for Amauri's birth parents, that you just give them comfort, Lord, knowing that he is with you now, Lord, doing things that he could not do on this side on earth, Lord. And we just pray now, Lord, that all things that will be done today will glorify you, and that you get the honor, the praise, and the glory. In your son Jesus' name I do pray. Amen.
At this time, we're going to have Sister Marianne Jameson bring us a musical selection called You Know Better Than I.
Thank you. do, Lord.
Okay. At this time, we're going to have an acknowledgement by Sister Ebony Woodward.
Thinking of you, you're in my thoughts and in my heart at this difficult time. Children's Hospital, the King's Daughters, doctors and staff, and some of the personal encouragements were thinking of you during this difficult time, Dr. Usher. And thinking of you and your family during this difficult time, Christina. And my prayers are with you at this difficult time. Okay. Heaven is where Jesus is, where worship fills every breath, where light fills every place, where love fills every heart, where peace fills every soul, where joys never cease. Heaven is our forever home. No eyes have seen, nor ears have heard, and no mind has imagined what God has prepared for those who love him. 1 Corinthians 2:9. Remembering you at this time of loss and praying that the reality of heaven's joy brings deep comfort to your heart. Love, James and Cheryl Newsom. May God comfort you. His eyes see each tear you cry. His ears hear your words of loss. His heart knows the pain that you feel. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Isaiah 53:4. And his arms hold you close, just as they do the one who has gone home to him. With sympathy and prayers from Pastor Willie and First Lady Shirley Hoskins and the Assembly of the Saints, No. 2 Ministries. So sorry for your loss, Pastor and family. As you take the time you need to remember and to heal, know you are in my prayers and in my heart. Blessings, Miss Linda. Okay. Time is God's gift. We all need a time to grieve, quiet time for reflection, to sift through the memories and to come to grips with what has happened. We all need a time for tears, not for the one who is now at peace with God in heaven, but for ourselves as we realize that things will never be the same. Pastor, Mrs. Morris, and Mr. Cairo, we all need a time to just be when we can feel the comfort and reassurance that God's everlasting love brings to heal our hearts. Praying God's peace and comfort for you in your loss. Only God can heal the pain of losing such a beautiful boy as Amauri. I am praying for comfort to get you all through the days ahead. Comfort and strength. Love, Tracy. Deepest sympathy. We would like to express our sincere condolences to you and your family from everyone at Chesapeake Department of Human Services Permanency Team. And I'll just read one of the many messages. It says, prayers lifted for the Morris family. Your son was a blessed young man who was loved by anyone and cherished, who came in his presence. Cherish the beautiful memories shared with your gift from God. Again, that was Tracy. And send thoughts and prayers to you and your loved ones during this difficult time. Lisa MC and Joshua 1 and 9. May you find peace and strength. Marley Lynn.
I believe at this time we have some tributes, some poems by Sister Janet Morris, the mother.
I am Janet Morris, Amauri's mom. And I'm also the poet in my family. I have often penned poems for many occasions, and I did one for my son, Amauri. And it's simply titled, A Tribute to Our Son. One bright morning, our sweet boy departed, leaving us hurt and brokenhearted. Lovable, affectionate, precious, fragile, and kind. Amauri, our sugar lump, was next in line. Next in line for his transition from earth to heaven, only 6 and a half, never to see 7. He held on so tight. He put up a good fight. But we thank God for our gift full of love. One day we will see him again in heaven above. That broken body he will have no more. Seeing him suffer hurt us to the core. Now we are rejoicing, knowing that he is in the presence of our Savior. Our sweet boy, oh glory, he was sinless and knew no misbehavior. We love that boy so much. Our hearts he truly touched. We held him in our arms night after night, lifting him up, praying that all would be all right. We miss him and we mourn for him. Our Lumpy, oh, was truly a gem. He will live on in our memories and in our hearts. Although we are many miles apart, we won't say goodbye, rather see you later beyond the sky. We love you, Amauri, forever. Thank you.
At this time, We're going to ask if anyone has expressions or reflections from families or friends Brother Morris has let me know that Sister Kay Washington from Health and Human Services is here, and she would like to say a few words.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Kay Washington. I'm with the Foster Care Unit at Chesapeake Department of Human Services. And I would like to ask all Chesapeake Human Services, past and present, people here today, can you please stand? Thank you, thank you. First, on behalf of the department, we'd like to give our condolences to Ms. Aria and Mr. Cordero, and we want to give definitely our condolences to the Morris family, Pastor Rick and Mrs. Morris in Cairo. So I first met Amauri in Cairo. I think Cairo was about to turn 3, and Amauri was about to turn 1, and I remember the day almost 5 years ago when I brought Amauri along with my coworker to the Morris home, what would become his family home, his forever home. Amauri was always bubbly, sweet, just had a wonderful spirit, joyful, smiling. He never could say a word, but you could tell that he was happy. He made sounds showing his joy. His eyes were so expressive, and he just displayed so much love. First, Amauri knew he was loved. He knew that his family loved him. He knew that his mom and dad loved him so much. His brother, when Cairo came in the room, the way he lit up, the way when Mrs. Morris would be on the couch, and Amauri wanted to get on that couch and sit right under her and lean up on her. When his dad came and got him and took him to all the appointments. He had so many appointments, but they took him to everyone, got him there, and made sure he was well taken care of. And Mr. June back there, that was the best nurse that Amauri could have. Oh, he did so well. He took such good care. So on behalf of the department, we want to thank the Morris family for being the wonderful parents that you are. Our job is not easy, but it helps us to know when the kids that we come in contact with go in such a loving and wonderful home. We know that you truly care. We know that you love what you do, and we know that you did all that you could and took the best care of Amauri. And I just want to say thank you, thank you, thank you for taking care of little God's angel Amauri. And we know Amauri is now there with God, and he's waiting for the day when we all come one day, and he's going to be running and laughing and smiling and joyful. And just want to say thank you, and I love you. And even though technically our relationship is professional, personally, you know how much you all mean to me, and how much Amauri and Cairo, Miss Aria, all of you mean to me. And so please let me know if there's anything that I can do to help you.
If we have any more expressions or reflections from friends or family, we just ask that you keep them under 2 minutes. That way the funeral directors can take care of their business. So.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Zaria. I'm Amauri's birth mom. I'm sorry, you guys.
It's okay.
Okay. I actually wrote some words for today. I don't know if I'm going to be able to read it, but I first want to say thank you to Pastor and Miss Jan. I want to say thank you for giving my sons a family and a home. I want to say thank you for being true people of God and giving my children an environment where they could grow up with God in their home. And I'm so glad that my son, regardless of his physical capabilities, he knew God, and we know that. When I was pregnant with Amauri, I could not find a name for him. I couldn't settle on a name, and about a month before he was born, my mom and I were choosing a name for him. And she said, "What about Amauri?" The name Amauri means unceasing vigor and unmatched bravery. And I didn't know when I was pregnant with him how brave he truly was going to be. Every day of my son's life, he woke up and he fought courageously. And he was so happy. Everyone knows he was so happy and beautiful, and he had a smile that would melt any heart. Anybody who met him, you couldn't help but to just love this baby. He was so beautiful, and to think how strong he was from a baby all the way up until his last moment, it makes me want to be strong like my son. I will never forget holding him and telling him how beautiful he was and looking into his beautiful eyes. I'll never forget the touch of his hand on my face. I'll never forget the feeling of love that I got from my son. I'll never forget the way he looked at me, the way he looked at his mom and his dad. I'll never forget our nights of movie nights and popcorn and just him gazing lovingly at his brother. He loved his brother so much. He was such a beautiful boy, and I'm gonna miss him a lot. That's all.
Praise the Lord, everybody. My name is Cindy. I'm Janet's niece. As she said, I'm the oldest niece. Amauri, everybody said everything about him. He was a happy child. He came to the family functions, and he would be in his little wheelchair. We would go to him and say, "Hi, Amauri," and he would just smile and rub his little, move his little body around. Every time someone came in the room, he knew you were there. Everyone that came and said his name, he would smile. He was a happy and blessed boy. Our prayers go out to the family, his mother and his father. We thank y'all for coming out. Look all the love here. This is love. This boy was only 6 years old. Look at this love. We continue to pray for everyone in Jesus' name.
Good morning, everyone. A lot of y'all might don't know me, but I'm the oldest of the Morris. This is my dad. This is my lovely stepmom. We got Amauri right here, Cairo. I'm looking at my brothers and my nieces and nephews. And I just want to tell everybody, man, love everyone, because you just never know. You just never know when it's your time to go. Amauri was definitely one of those ones. He always, like the lady was saying, man, I don't know if I even spoke to you, ma'am, but I remember getting a phone call for the interview for my dad and Janet. They gave me a call and asked, was my dad a good person? So what y'all thought I was gonna say? Of course, but now you can see, he practiced what he's preaching. We always grew up like that. And Cairo, you always gonna be my little brother. I got you, okay? Love you, bro. I love y'all.
Good morning, everyone. I am just so happy to see everyone here. My name is Willa Alexander. That's my husband, Deacon Alexander. And this is my favorite brother, whom I love with all my heart and all my soul. And he knows that. And my only sister-in-law right there, who has been a blessing to my brother. You know, I told my brother that we're all here on earth, and we have a purpose. Many of us don't know what that purpose is. We have an assignment, and many of us don't know what that assignment is. But I say to you, to just go and pray and find out what God has for you. Amauri, verbally, well not verbally, but he knew what his assignment was. He was placed here for a purpose, and his purpose was my brother. And his purpose was Jan. When your assignment is over, you finish the race. Now you can come home and be with the Lord. And Jesus, he was Amauri's ram in the bush. He was. He finished his race. His assignment was completed. And from that, my brother and Jan, I know that they developed something probably that they did not know in the beginning, and how to love unconditionally. And that's what they were taught. That's what we all need to know, how to love unconditionally. My nephew here says, love one another, and that's what we all need to do. Not bickering, not fighting, not being angry with family members, none of that. Love one another. Know what your purpose is here on earth. Amen.
Good morning. My name is Renee Morris. I am the grandchild of Sister Jan and Pastor Ricky Morris. And the summer of 23, I spent the summer with my grandfather. And I would just like to say that Amauri was so loved. And my grandfather is the best man alive. Like, he's my role model. Like, every day, it's not a day that if Amauri needed something, he's rushing. He's there. He's never not there. And I would just like to say that he was blessed and loved, and I love everybody.
Pastor Morris, Reverend Jan Morris and all the ministers, and to the birth mom of Amauri, her parents, and to the family and friends, we are truly here today to on behalf of the Bellamy Avenue Church of God in Norfolk to express to you that our prayers are with you and are for you. It said that earth loss is heaven's gain, and I believe that is well expressed here today from the poem that Reverend Janet shared and from the expression for the birth mom and other expressions that Morris certainly has been a loss to the earth. But heaven's gain, which means is his life here on earth is a better change for him in heaven, because his affliction is no longer existent. He's now have been healed and well healed and in the presence of the Lord. But the love that was shown to him in his affliction is so permanent and so enormous that I believe that even in his affliction, he knew the love that he received was a such that certainly helped to alleviate many of his suffering in this life. I want to say that God is a good and a gracious God. I want to say to your family and friends and all, say, weeping may endure for a night, but joy does come in the morning. And so weep on, mourn on, but God will bring you with joy as you continue to reflect on Amauri and reflect on how so many have been touched by his life within the 6 years of his life. Many of us will not be touched like Amauri touch your life. Keep on loving, keep on expressing it, keep on showing it, but especially love God with all your heart, mind, and soul, and love one another. This is what God's great commandment is to us. Love him, love yourself, love one another. God bless you.
Good morning, saints.
Good morning.
My name is James E. Newsom, Jr. And as I'm saying, I just want to say this real good, and I want y'all to open your ears up and listen. Hallelujah! 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 Glory to God. know what? My brother down there, you know, he had no sin or nothing. I knew we wish we was like that. I knew we wish we were like that. With no sin. Hallelujah! I know we wish we was like that. But we're not. We got a long ways to go. And a short time to get there. This man here, Pastor Rick Morris, he carried this baby. I mean, he carried him like this when he was little, like this. When he was 6 years old, he still hold him like this. He showed this baby love. And he said he learned from this baby about love. This man is a glory to God. He's a man of peace, a man of joy. Amen. And I love him. Amen. Because this is what he showed me. This is what he showed me. So I just want to say, hallelujah! Hallelujah! Glory to God.
Minister Joseph Lindsay to say a few words.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
I said, praise the Lord, everybody. This is a homegoing. This is a homegoing. Good God Almighty. The situation we have here, he was here to help us. The whole while we thought we was helping him. Everybody that gave joy, everybody that gave love to him, we thought we was helping him, but he was teaching us how to love. You see, God got a way of doing things. He'll take the simplest, the most helpless, the smallest love or the smallest situation and do something big. Unconditional love. The very love that he showed is the same love that Jesus Christ showed. Unconditional love. You learn to love somebody when, I'm going to say this and I'm going to sit down. Okay, this is what the Lord put on my heart. When you can learn to love somebody that can't give you nothing back. When you can learn to love somebody that can't even lift a finger to give you a glass of water. When you can learn to love somebody that can't help you do anything, can't even tell you thank you, when you can learn to love like that. Good God Almighty. That's not the world love. Because you see, the world love is I'm going to do for you as long as you do for me. When you stop doing for me, then I'm going to stop doing for you. But see they learn to love knowing that they would never get nothing in return. That's a lesson that everybody here can learn. If you haven't learned it yet, we can learn that. Unconditional love. Love without expecting. Love with knowing that nothing's coming back their way. The question that I want you to ask yourselves, can I love like that? Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Okay, at this time we're going to have a silent reading of the obituary. This time we're going to have Sister Marianne Jameson bring a musical selection called My Help. At this time, we're going to ask Pastor Ricky Morris, the father, to bring the eulogy.
I feel like Brother James. Praise the Lord. Oh, God is good, I tell you. Just of myself, I couldn't have given him a better home going. There's an old adage that says it takes a village to raise a child. Let me tell you something. Amauri's village showed up. Between yesterday and today, how God blessed. I'm going to tell you something. It's something about the power of love. You tell me how amazing for someone that had cerebral palsy, a seizure disorder, nonverbal, amen, who command the attention of so many folks. His love, that's because the love of God was in him. In all of his suffering, Amauri smiled. Do you hear me? I can remember when he learned to even laugh, and because he was battling such conditions. One time he's in hospital 22 days, another time 24 days, another time 32 days. But God will come in, amen, and God will intervene every single time, and he will deliver him. But in all those times, he always smiled. CHKD, which is one of the best children's hospital in the world, they were so amazed about this child that when he showed up and his name appeared on the board, let me tell you, they were coming to see about him. I won't forget as the day he gave his last breath, and they knew he was in that emergency room. They were coming from everywhere. Doctors, therapists, all kinds of people showed up. His school system showed up. The Department of Social Services, they showed up. Do you hear me? He was loved. He had that kind of drawing power. But I'm going to tell you something. A lot of times people comment you. And they said, oh, you and your wife, you know, that's a wonderful thing that, you know, to take care of a special need child. And I can remember in times I would look, I couldn't understand how people could do it. But it was something different about this child. And I realized all those days that I spent in his room became my altar. Do you hear me? I never had a walk like God until Amauri came in my life. I was saved. I was living to all I know. I was preaching to all I know. But it was something about his love that kept me on my knees. Do you understand me? Taught me how to pray more, how to love more. He taught me about unconditional love. To how to love someone when they don't love you back. Do you understand me? Amen. He touched the untouchable and he loved the unlovable. Let me tell you, he was an amazing child. Then I came to my conclusion. You know what? I'm not here to help him. He's here to help me. I am his assignment. And he had a mission. Do you understand? I remember one time I was talking to God at his bedside. And the Lord said to me, "You love him very much." I said, "Yay, Lord." And the Lord spoke back. He said, "That's how much I love you." Then the Lord had me look at him. "He's broken." I said, "Yay, Lord." He said, "You were broken too, but I fixed you." And he said, "I like fixing broken things." Do you hear me? Amen. He took me to the potter's house. Do you hear me? Amen. And he used, amen, that lump of clay, amen, to make me over again.
That's right.
So I don't regret him ever being in my life. If I could lay everything I've ever done, if there were accolades given to me, there is none higher, no higher calling than I had to be the dad of Amauri DeAngelo Morris. Do you hear me? He was a very unique young man. Amen. And I began to watch him grow. I remember when he began to go to school 3 days a week, how excited about the school. But see, I learned what I learned from him. At first, I was trying to get him to come into my world. And the Lord had to show me, you got to learn how to go into his world.
That's right.
And when I began to go into his world, oh, he was just so affectionate, so lovable. Oh, my God. And it's just, even though weakly, he would just grab my finger sometime and hold it. He got to the point he'd look for me. And I tell you, God got a way of encouraging you. There's never been a time that I felt I couldn't do this. I couldn't take care of him. I don't care if I had to crawl in there. I was going to take care of my son. But sometimes you need encouragement. And when he passed, my nephew came over to my house. That's this young man back here. Matter of fact, both of these are my nephews. And those are all most of them my sons that are out here. And my daughter, amen. But he came over, and as he sat at the table, because in time past, he have encouraged me. I can remember when I was building that church, and I called him one day. I said, "I'm pretty tired." And I said, "Because I'm dealing with all these folks, these contractors, and you know what I mean. It was a job building." And he always called me Unc. I call him nephew. He called me Unc. "Hey, Unc." So he said, "Well, consider it like this. While you building that church, God is building you." Now, he said that at that time, but he came back the other day when he brought that food, him and his wife, Pat. And he sat there again. Here he go with one of those Unk sayings. So he said, hey, Unk. And he encouraged me. He said, you know what? He had to go first. Because, see, if he hadn't have went first and you went first, he would have been looking for you. And I had been praying this prayer. You got to be careful what you pray for. Because sometimes God doesn't answer like you think he should answer. I said, Lord, here it is. I'm going to turn 72 this year. My wife, I ain't going to tell her age, but she ain't far behind me. And who is going to take care of him? I looked on the right. Well, everybody was just about old as me on my side. On her side, everybody was pretty much old as she. And so sometimes, and young people, and I'm not saying this to condemn, a lot of them have their own lives. And he was a special need child, and you had to have special love. So I'm reminded of the time when Abraham was called to make the ultimate sacrifice for his son. So God called him, and he took Isaac up there on Mount Moriah, and he was getting ready to sacrifice him. And the angel called out of heaven, and that angel said, no, don't take him. I'm kind of paraphrasing it. And as he looked, there was a what? A ram in the bush. Now I had been praying that prayer, and God came back and told me Jesus was my ram in the bush. He took Amauri, because nobody, do you hear me? Nobody can care for him and give him the love that he needed like Jesus. Do you hear me? So he came and took him home. And it was one of those things, well, Lord, I know you was going to answer like that. But my heart says, amen to his will. And what I like, I can't preach his funeral. Everybody else here preach it. But I want to share one scripture with you, and I'm going to leave it with you. Matthew, and I can read it to you. The 18th chapter, and listen to this. Starting at the first, I'm going to read 1 through 6. He said, at the same time came the disciples unto Jesus, saying, who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven? And Jesus called a little child unto him and set him in the midst of them. And he said, verily I say unto you, except you be converted and become as little children, you shall not enter into the kingdom of heaven. Whosoever therefore, amen, shall humble himself as this little child, the same is greatest in the kingdom of heaven. Well, why is this so? Because it's something about a child's love. It's something about a child's affection. Children can play, amen, and fall out and argue, and Johnny might pick up his marbles and go home. But the next day, he's back to try it again. A child don't hold malice. Come on. Come on. A child don't divide and disfellowship you or can't see you. And that's the problem. We want to call ourselves brothers and sisters in the Lord, where we got to love like him. And it's not just, amen, to go around perpetrating a false love, but we got to have that agape love, a love that calls us to love unconditional, despite your brother's shortcoming, despite the color of his hair, amen. Despite the color of his skin, you gotta love him unconditionally.
That's right.
Some of the things these people are dividing over, they don't know what love is. But it's one thing this little lad taught me. It was unconditional love.
That's right.
That I'm not going to love you because you love me.
That's right.
I'm going to love you if you don't love me.
That's right.
You know why? Because I want to go to heaven.
That's right. Yes, sir.
You can't go to heaven if you don't love your brother.
That's right. Yes, sir.
Come on. You can't go to heaven if you don't forgive your brother.
That's right.
From the heart. Come on. And that's the problem. We just go on and we just take God for granted. And let me tell you something. You don't know when God gonna come and get you.
That's right.
The parents are not supposed to, we have this adage, the parents is not supposed to bury the children, but the children the parents.
Amen.
But we see it different in this time, doesn't it?
That's right.
Amen. The Bible let us know, be ye also ready, for an hour you think not the Lord coming.
That's
now
right.
When he come, have you cleared up the things you need to clear up?
Right.
Have you forgiven the person you need to forgive? Are you holding people? Amen. You can't go and fit in God's heaven like that. Your love have to be unconditional.
Yes.
And when he did that act of feet washing, he showed it, didn't he?
Yes.
You have to love one another in spite of.
Yes.
Even if it don't feel good.
Right.
Now, I'm not saying you got to like everything a person does, but you better love them.
Right.
Let me tell you something. You better not die, amen, with hate in your heart. And you know what hate is? Hate is to love less.
Right. All right.
Hate is to love less than what God requires.
Yes.
So we got to make it. I want to make heaven my home.
Yes.
And I tell you, this week I saw a silhouette of a man. Amen. And he was holding a child. And the Lord, he didn't show me, but he just showed me the silhouette. And I took that to be Jesus holding Amauri. He's waiting on me. So you know what? I'm going to do everything that I can to love you. And I don't care if you don't love me back. To forgive you. And if you don't forgive me back. Let me tell you something, because you got to answer to God. Because I want to see Jesus face in peace, and I want to see Amauri. Amen. Because guess what? I got landscape in heaven now. I got property in heaven now. Do you hear me? So I thank God for all of you coming. I appreciate it, and I thank God that his village showed up. Amen. And the Bible said, give honor to whom honor is due. And I want to thank his birth mom for giving me such a wonderful boy. I remember how she, that day, you know, because different one would come and train how to take care of him. And let me tell you something, it took a whole lot. It took 24/7. She said, and she's seen how much we love him. And so she decided to give him to me and my wife.
Amen.
Amen. To care for him. And I hope you don't ever think we let you down. But we loved him. He has never even had a raised voice at him at all. He exuberated love. And look, when you walked in this room, it was almost like, amen, standing in God's presence, because God was in that room with that child. So I thank God he was a blessing. So a lot of us, we had him for a little time. Amen. But if you want to see him again, I know we use that term, thank you for your loss. I'm sorry you lost, but I'm going to tell you something. He's not lost. Amen. He's not lost. Because that day is coming in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, and that trump shall sound. The dead in Christ, yes, amen, shall rise first, and we who are alive shall be caught up together to meet the Lord in the air. One day we're going to see his face,
yes,
in peace.
Amen.
So you all continue to pray for the family. And I want to do something a little different that's a little different. Pastor Joby, can you come up here a second? Come up. I want you to pray and leave us in God's love and care. Come on over here. This is our cousin, right? Cousin, nephew, best friend. All Amauri brothers, stand up. Stand up. That's it. All Amauri cousins, stand up. First cousins and second cousins. Come on, children, all y'all, stand up. All Amauri's nieces and nephews, you know he was an uncle too, stand up. So Amauri was surrounded by a family of love. Amen. So may God bless you. Do the honors.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Pastor. Family and friends, what we desire today, because we can't change what God has allowed, but God will give us peace in the coming days and months, and he'll give us strength to be able to go forth. Amen. As Pastor was preaching, I kept thinking, what next, you know, what next? I've done so many funerals this past year, but never been part of one at this age. And my saying has always been that death should bring life. Because of what we have witnessed this past week, we know that death is real. Amen. And it's going to continue to happen as long as we exist. But every day is a gift from the Lord. And we must treasure our gifts. So as we go forth as a family and as friends, let us be the best that we can be, because who knows who's going to be next. Amen. So we're going to pray for the family, and thank you for giving me this opportunity, that God will give us strength and peace. And he'll do that. God is our strength and he is our peace. So let us pray. Father, in your precious name, we do thank you for this day that you have given us. Today is a gift from you, and we cherish it and we appreciate it. You have been there for so many times, in so many ways, through so many struggles of life. Today, as the family come together to celebrate the life of Amauri, my God, we ask them to ask you that you give them peace, my God, to accept what you have allowed, give them strength to go forth. Allow them to embrace each other in the coming weeks, in the coming days. My God, you never fail. There is no failure in the Lord. My God, we learn to accept whatever you do, because you do all things well. My God, you love Amauri even more than we could ever imagine. You have taken him out of his suffering. You have done a wonderful thing. Now he is in the presence of the Lord, and we're happy about that. Amen. We cherish the times we've had with him. We cherish the memories, all of the smiles and the hugs. But now, Lord, we go forth in your name. We ask that you would just keep us. My God, there was no bitterness among us. There is only joy and peace, because you are our peace. We thank you, Lord, for the family. Continue to encourage their hearts and strengthen them as we all go forth. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.